It's a profession that stretches back hundreds of years, but modern-day farriers require extensive knowledge of equine anatomy and physiology, and they are an invaluable part of a racehorse's support network.
The horse's heavy training schedule puts an increased strain on their feet. Here's the farrier's chest. It is therefore essential that they get really good shoeing, because there's an old saying which goes, no hoof, no horse.
Depending on how often they run, a racehorse might see a farrier as much as every 10 days. With a team of up to 8 on site at trainer William Haggis' yard, they can be shoeing up to 40 horses a day.
Hi, Billy, you're the resident farrier here.
Yeah, I am, yeah.
Plenty of horses to look after, and you're just going to be putting a shoe back on this one.
Yep, this chap's got a run coming up, so we're just about halfway through plating him. So we're going to just apply the other plate to him, and then he's ready to run.
So when you say plates, I mean, these are racing plates, so these are sort of lightweight.
These are lightweight. They are, that's correct. Yes, yeah, so lightweight. You can feel how light they are. When they're just in regular training, they'll wear a steel shoe, and that's purely for durability and wear. The aluminiums, they're more for the running, but they don't wear as well in everyday training, walking on the concrete and tarmac.
And the horses don't mind this? I guess they're so used to it?
That's right, they do. They're very used to it. They've been handled from a young age. But yeah, you're going into the non-sensitive structures of the hoof. So if we're accurate and we get it right, they shouldn't feel it.
So before a horse goes to a race course, before a horse runs, they have to have a new set of shoes on.
That's
every
right,
time?
Yep. So we get maximum traction when they're running, so they've got a brand new shoe on, and we know that it's on safe, new nails, everything's tight and it's safe, ready to go on race day. So then that's him, finished up, good boy.
Put some nail polish on.
That's it, a bit of grease. And then also the important part of the hoof, the underneath, we take care of that.
So what are you putting on here?
So basically we're putting on a antibacterial solution that obviously these horses standing in the stalls all day long, standing manure, it's just making sure the foot stays healthy and clean.
Looks a good job to me.
So yeah, that's him done, ready to give us another first place hopefully.
Tell me then, why is a farrier so integral to the team behind a horse?
I think good farriers have become more a part of the teams because we're becoming observers. So we spend a lot of time with the horses on our own, and you pick up things that you can transport back to head lads, vets, trainers. So we're looking after the feet, and that's very important, but also we can pick up on other stuff and transport that back. So it's, you know, part of that role. I don't essentially believe that farriers can make horses run faster, but if we can keep them sounder, they can stay in training for longer, hence getting fitter, and then they can win their races.
Now in its sixth year, British Champions Day is a fitting finale to the European flat racing season. It's an autumnal morning at Ascot Racecourse, and the Fashionistas are out in their winter finery on the UK's richest race day. Some of the world's greatest horses and jockeys would do battle for the £4.2 million in prize money. Having recently run in Canada, Champions Day came too early for William Haggis' Mutter Kaif. In racing, not everything always goes to plan, but the trainer was quick to praise his team back at Somerville Lodge.
Well, I always say that it's a fantastic job I have, because I get all the glory if they win, and I don't do any of the work. So over the course of 30 years, we've assembled a great team of people, and we are fantastic to deliver the horses at occasions like this in the best shape possible. When we try and build a family spirit in the place, and you know, our motto is if you work hard, you will be rewarded, whether it's financially or otherwise.
Feature race here this afternoon is the Kitco Champion Stakes, and fresh from her big win in the Prix de l'Arc de Triomphe, where we were lucky enough to be behind the scenes with her team, Found is looking for another big win for trainer Aidan O'Brien.
A packed crowd looked on as the favourite Almanzor rekindled his rivalry with Found, who he'd beaten in last month's Irish Champion Stakes.
It's Almanzor once again repelling Found. There is no doubt he is a champion. Almanzor, what a season for Jean-Claude Rouget.
The £700,000 prize purse headed to France, but it had been another good day for Ireland's Aidan O'Brien. as well as Found's second and earlier win in the QE2 stakes, means that he's closing in and needs just four more top-level wins to equal Bobby Frankel's world record of 25 in a year.
Well, Aidan, congratulations. Second with Found. You must be delighted that 2 weeks after winning the Arch, you can come here and put up another really good performance.
Yeah, and she amazing filly. Obviously, the lads done a great job to get her here and keep her as happy as she is. But she's an amazing filly, really.
Now, we were behind the scenes with your horses at the Prix de l'Arc de Triomphe, and we were lucky enough to follow Patter for a while. He's an integral member of your team.
Oh, Pat, unbelievable fella. Like, Pat travels everything day in, day out. Very special fella, and he does an unbelievably wonderful job. It's all about the team, and we really appreciate everyone's hard work, and that's what it is. And like we are only a very small part of a very big team, really, but it's all pure teamwork all the way along, absolutely.
Well, win or lose, the trainers can't speak highly enough about their teams, and we've seen firsthand how important a part they play. That's it, though, for this month. In next month's episode, we'll be in California for the Breeders' Cup. And we'll also be meeting the agents who'll be bidding on some of the world's most expensive thoroughbreds when we hit the sales in Kentucky.